you, ladies and gentlemen. So, Yasmin and Hannah will lead a Q&A. So if you have any questions for our actors about anything you've seen today or anything they've done in the last 10 weeks or about the research itself, please just put your hand up or shout it out. Shall we?
Can you just say your name as well?
Hi, I'm Shakiba. I was just wondering, are these words that you said actually the words of people?
Yeah.
So it's
a
probation.
No, not entirely. The officials weren't real people.
It's like when people said speeches, that's really.
Yeah. They're taking like interviews and stuff.
How did you feel when you were giving those speeches? Because some of them were quite heavy, weren't they?
It made me understand a lot about like immigration, how it makes people feel. Because like you don't really think about it on a day-to-day basis, but after doing the pay and knowing about their real stories, I understand a bit more how they'll feel.
Any more questions from the audience?
Or observations or comments?
There's one there, and then we'll
How many buses were there, and did anyone take any action on the buses?
So there were two vans, and they were driven through six of the most ethnically diverse boroughs in London. It was supposed to be a pilot scheme, but actually there was a lot of opposition to the vans, so they stopped after 2 weeks. But the wider sort of Operation Bacon, which they were talking about, carried on for a month. It cost about just over £9,000 for that campaign. And as we were told, the actual numbers of people who went home, it was about voluntary deportations, and the numbers were very small. It was very interesting because there was a breakdown of who had called the number. So on the van, there was a number that you could text or you could phone, and quite a large percentage of people who call that number were hoax calls. So, for example, somebody who's called Pucker Punjabi on Twitter phoned the number and asked if she could be taken home to Harsden, which is another place in London. So that's an example of some of the how people resisted the bans in different ways.
There was another question in the middle there.
Yeah, what was that? It's just a question. What were you trying to find with the research?
What were we trying to find with the research?
Yeah, what was the research question you were trying to answer?
We wanted to know what, so this, there was the van and there were several other interventions, so there was lots of publicity about how tough the Home Office was being on immigration. And what we wanted to find out was what the effects of that were on everyday life. So that included people, so you heard a lot of different stories from the cast, so there were lots of people who were asylum seekers or refugees, but also people who were just living in London, whether they were had immigrant backgrounds or not, and some people who were in favour of more tough immigration control. And we wanted to know what these campaigns were doing to those conversations. So I think the play did a really good job of bringing those different stories to life.
What did
the Home Office actually think they were going to achieve? that's the actual text that was on the van. So the public story from the minister at the time was this is about people who might not have the right papers and who want to kind of resolve that, and they can get there. There was other signs in reporting centres that said we can book your tickets to go home. So they were saying you can have voluntary returns to your place of origin. So they were trying to kind of get people to take up that offer rather than to do raids. But the language itself was so strong and those echoes of people being told to go home, that it felt like there was... We never got anyone to tell us exactly what was going on, but really all we found out was that it was about showing how tough the language was.
Hello, Mary, my name. I was wondering if also that triggered people calling, saying, oh, I think my neighbour, is he illegally, can you check on him, or something like that, you know, like... Did they get such calls?
We don't. The breakdown didn't actually give those statistics for people calling in with claims. But I mean, that is partly that people did feel that they, this was encouraging that sort of snooping.
Yeah.
So that was, I mean, I think what's really interesting for us is 5 years after the bans, what happened in at the beginning of 2018 was the so-called Windrush scandal, where the hostile environment, it was called, you know, which Theresa May sort of first started speaking about in 2012, we've been able to sort of see what that's meant. So while this was a very visible, we've called it a sort of performance politics, you know, to say we're really tough on immigration, what the Windrush situation has shown is that for the past few years behind the scenes, there's been a creeping insecuritisation where long-term residents have been deported, detained, lost access to healthcare, and you know, some people have lost their housing. So it's very interesting for us to see this sort of what seemed like a very small, ill-thought-out campaign was actually part of this larger hostile environment politics, really.
And do you think that had an impact on the Brexit vote at the end?
It's really, really interesting because we the book from our research, Hannah and I were just editing it just before the Brexit vote, and it was also just after the murder of the Labour MP Joe Cox. And it was really interesting. I think some of the things we were picking up in our research, so for example, some of my research was with people from the far right political party, the BNP, and some of those same narratives about feeling this was the white working class who weren't being listened to, we want to take back control, was very much the narratives we were hearing, really. So it's quite eerie when some of the publicity around Brexit and then afterwards, so in the 2 weeks after the Brexit referendum, the incident of hate crimes based on race and faith doubled. So I do think it's kind of related.
Do you have any more questions, maybe to any of our performers about any thoughts they had about performing? Or performers, do you have any questions for the audience?
Yes.
Go either way.
Miss Kay's got a question.
And for the students, please, do you think that this play has changed your understanding of immigration? And if it has, how, please?
Definitely, like, pretty sure it changed like everyone's understanding, like the play, and it changed my understanding, like to like understand like even people who aren't like immigrants, like illegal immigrants can be affected in a way.
Yeah. It also like shows that kind of shows us how like disrespectful the authorities can be. So like the idea of the puppet, so that they don't even give an actual like. Because the puppet's supposed to be, I think, a robot, right? So they're not even a proper human being, and they can't understand different people's like stories and different situations. So having like a puppet like sort out the borders like shouldn't really be. It kind of shows like how disrespectful and like how rude the like authorities are.
There's a hand over there that went up a little while ago. Do you want to say something?
I was just wondering, if the government ever like released like a formal statement, like what did they ever say? Did they explain themselves? Like, what did they say about this?
It's a really good question. A few days after the first Go Home bans were spotted, the immigration minister Mark Harper wrote an article in the Daily Mail. Saying because there were these bans quickly got dubbed the racist bans on social media, and so he did give an explanation to say that the sole point of them was for people who were here illegally to receive a very strong message that they weren't welcome and they should go home. So that was kind of the official explanation, and then they did a report a few months later, but there was. Very quickly, because it was in the news headlines, and it's very interesting. After the Windrush sort of cases started coming up, the Go Home bans were in the media again. So that was the official sort of explanation given.
Did you have a question?
Yeah, Yeah, what did the audience think of the play?
I think she wants more.
They don't really have anyone, especially if they're like one like person coming over or like three people, they're not going to have a lot of people that they know. So I think trying to find those people and find someone for them to talk to about it, and especially if they know like it's a child, they know that it's like really is something that they can talk to. Yeah.
Would you consider doing performance in other schools?
Yeah. Okay. We're all tall. Buy your tickets now.
What is it
called?
Have you performed it to your school, or are you going to perform it to your school?
No.
No.
Our school is too
low. Last thing we do.
Okay, thank you so much. And I think these amazing actors deserve one more round of applause.
For doing this for our children, because I think they've learned so much. What a great opportunity for them to go to university, to learn about the subject as well. So thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.